6 Minute English from BBC Learning English.
Hello, this is 6 Minute English. I'm Rob.
And I'm Neil.
Now, Neil, are you a tidy person?
Me? Oh dear, no. You should see my floordrobe.
Your floordrobe?
Yes. Tidy people keep their clothes in a wardrobe. I just dump a lot of my clothes on the floor. So, a floordrobe.
Ah, yes. Well, it sounds as if you could use a bit of decluttering. Clutter is the word for general mess and untidiness when you have too many things, too much stuff. These days, the idea of decluttering is very popular.
Ooh, I love a good declutter. Trouble is, I hate throwing things away.
Well, we might have some advice for you in today's programme. But first, a question. It's about cleaning up. The vacuum cleaner is a machine we use to clean our houses. When were the first mechanical floor cleaners, which later became vacuum cleaners, invented? Was it A, the 1860s, B, the 1890s, or C, the 1920s?
Well, you know what? I have no idea. So I'll say the 1890s.
OK, well, I'll have the answer later in the programme. The decluttering techniques of Marie Kondo are very popular these days. A UK decluttering expert, Leslie Spellman, appeared on the BBC radio programme You and Yours to discuss the topic. She was asked to describe the basics of the Marie Kondo method. What's the first thing she recommends people start with?
She basically says you have to do things in a certain order. You have to start with your clothes, then you move on to your books, then you move on to paperwork, then you go on to something called kimono, which is kind of everything else, kitchens, bathrooms, garages, lofts, etc. And then finally you tackle sentimental things.
She says that you have to start with your clothes before moving on through different categories of clutter.
The verb she uses for dealing with these things is to tackle. To tackle something means to deal with it, to sort it out.
And the last things she says you need to tackle are sentimental things. These are things that you have an emotional connection to, such as old letters and photographs. I have to say, those are the things I find most difficult to get rid of. I'm very sentimental like that.
I think you just have to be ruthless, Rob. Either that or buy a bigger house. Right, let's listen to Leslie Spellman again.
She basically says you have to do things in a certain order. You have to start with your clothes, then you move on to your books, then you move on to paperwork, then you go on to something called kimono, which is kind of everything else, kitchens, bathrooms, garages, lofts, etc. And then finally you tackle sentimental things.
So why is it that decluttering is such big business these days? And there are many people and companies offering advice and services. Here's Leslie Spellman again with her thoughts on this.
I think there's been a big shift, really. So my generation, my parents, you know, definitely came from that make-do and mend era post-war in the sort of 20th century. And then all of a sudden, people started to get a little bit more money. Things became more affordable. You can buy 5 tops for £5 each. And people have done that. And that's allowed consumerism to kind of go crazy in the 21st century.
So what does she put our need for decluttering down to?
Well, first she says that there has been a shift in our behaviour. This is a way of saying that there has been a change in the way we behave. We used to make do and mend much more. This phrase means that we made full use of what we had, and if something broke, we tried to fix it.
And these days, we seem to have more money, and many goods have got cheaper, and we just like buying stuff. Or, as she says, consumerism has gone crazy. Let's listen to her again.
I think there's been a big shift, really. So my generation, my parents, you know, definitely came from that make-do and mend era post-war in the sort of 20th century. And then all of a sudden, people started to get a little bit more money. Things became more affordable. You can buy 5 tops for £5 each. And people have done that. And that's allowed consumerism to kind of go crazy in the 21st century.
Time to tidy up today's vocabulary. But first, let's have the answer to the question. Earlier, I asked you, when were the first mechanical floor cleaners invented? Was it in A, the 1860s, B, the 1890s, or C, the 1920s? And Neil, you said...
I guessed at the 1890s.
Sadly not. The correct answer is the 1860s. So, well done to anyone who got that right. Now on with today's vocabulary. The first word we had was floordrobe.
Yes, this is a word to describe a pile of clothes that someone keeps on the floor rather than in a wardrobe.
Well, I don't have a floordrobe, but I do have a chairdrobe. I guess you can work out what that means. Anyway, it seems we both have too much clutter. which is the untidiness caused by having too many things.
And this leads us to the popular pastime of decluttering, which is throwing away things to make our homes neat and tidy.
Clutter in my life is an issue I haven't tackled yet. I haven't tried to fix it or sort it out.
One area that the experts say you need to tackle is sentimental things. These are things which you have an emotional connection to, maybe old letters and photographs, for example.
We then looked at the word shift, which was a way of saying change. There has been a shift or a change in the way we think about things.
Yes, rather than an attitude of make, do and mend, which means an attitude of being content with what you've got and fixing things if they break, we've become part of a consumerist culture where we like to buy more and more stuff.
But we still find it hard to throw things away.
Yes, indeed we do. Well, it's time for us to collect our scripts and declutter the studio. We look forward to your company next time. And until then, you can find us in all the usual places, online and on social media. Just look for BBC Learning English. Bye for now.
Bye-bye.
6 Minute English from bbclearningenglish.com.
Hi everybody, it's Neil from BBC Learning English here. Did you enjoy that video? Of course you enjoyed that video. You love our videos, which is why you need to subscribe. And then you can see as many of our videos as you like and improve your English. Tell your friends too. Enjoy!